Hi, this is Vema Reddy. So today we will see a simple example how we can convert the JSON array string to as a kind of array to string conversion. So let's see a simple example here. This is how my JSON object looks like. I will be taking one array as an input here. So the array has two objects. The first object is a name is John and age is 30 and car is a list of car, BMW things. And here if you notice the car is an array element here. So again you will see a name, age and second object has a Hyundai, Maruti, Honda. So most of the times we will face a difficulty in converting this list of array objects into a string, something like that. Something I want like this. First array, it should have the Ford, BMW with comma. You need to convert basically array to string. So if you go with other tools, integration tools, it's pretty simple. So, but when it comes to a Boomi, it's kind of a bit challenging the way how it processes the data. So let's see a simple, for saving the time, I have already created a process and I'll just walk through how it looks like and what are the things we need to do. So basically the key thing what we need to do is we need to access this particular object using a JavaScript and this JavaScript will try to access this list of arrays and convert it to and store it in a property. So we'll use that property. So let's see, first I'm taking the input. Since message shape will accept double quotes as a special character, so I just passing as a static value. Where here I passed entire input JSON here. It has a both array, two array elements. So after that, what I just do is I just splitted the element here based on I have created a JSON profile matching to this input data. So here is a JSON structure. You can see root is an array. So in the array, it has a list of objects. Each object has a name and age. And again, car is an array. Here it's a car has a elements array element. This is a sample structure. So what I am doing here, first I'm splitting it based on the record. So array elements, okay? First I'm splitting it array elements. So that every time we'll be getting only first, when the first document will have this array element, second document will have this object, second object. So like that, after that, what I am doing, I'm just storing entire the object into a property called cars here. You can see I'm defining one dynamic document property. So here I'm taking entire data, current data as a, it means basically what we'll get it, every document is a basically one JSON object I'm storing into a one dynamic document property called cars. So let's go to map here. So what I'm doing here is, so I created, I selected the source JSON data profile as a source profile. And here I just converted created one user defined function here. In this user defined function, I have created one JavaScript here. So where whatever the set I already there, I just extracted that one and then, and then I use a script function here. The script function basically it just whatever the input input means basically it's current entire JSON object, and this JSON object I am parsing it with parsing using text, and so that I'll be getting an object. So I'm looping it to I'm retrieving the object data. I'm retrieving cars inside this one. So my looks like when splitting is done. Basically, this is how the array element will be there, including square brackets. That's the reason I'm taking my object of 0, so that because always we're getting only one document because since we already split it. So then next element is the cars is the element. So this is an array element. So I'm taking the length here. So I'm iterating the length. So each and I'm defining one variable to use to accumulate this one. So let's define this value and I'm accumulating with comma here. You can see every time I'm accumulating with comma. So that's how the index is active, and then I'm setting that at last. I'm just setting substring of comma because for first position will be getting a comma. That's why I'm taking from the first position onwards. I'm taking entire input. I'm mapping it to an output here. So that actually map it to a car element here. So I'll be getting one record. Every one record I'll be getting. So I'll be converting that into a. I'll be combining the document here. and then I'm displaying it here. So let's run it. So after splitting the document, you can see two documents came, and each document has one object here. You can see one JSON object here, but still you can see it's array. It means basically it's a one array element, one array of with one document. So then basically here we are getting converting that into here cars. You can see if the cars is a dynamic document property that stores entire object data, entire current data. So you can see this object. So then in the current script, basically we are converting the first Honda Maruti like this. So like this we are converting, and after that we are combining the documents. This is how the data looks like after the map output. Basically we'll get the data into a flat file, and this is after combining, you will see the output like this. Okay, thank you.